Welcome back, everyone. Today we wanted to do a test on our solar panels again and show you how much power you can get out of about 200 to 220 watts of solar. We've got two of the Harbor Freight 100 watt panels up there, an older one and a newer one. As you can see, the grid configuration is a little different. Behind it are the old sets of Harbor Freight panels, that's old 25 watt panels, but those aren't producing much power right now. So total system power, we're getting about 220 out. So that's going down into a PWM charge controller and charging a 200 amp hour battery. So on a good day, 100 watt panel should give you anywhere between 350 and 500 watt hours of power for the day. So collectively out of this, on a good day, 1,000 watt hours would be perfect. I don't think we're gonna get that, maybe around 700 or 800, because it is getting towards the winter. We also wanna note that inside the wiring and the fuse are set up there so that we can take it down really quick and swap things out, because nothing's permanent right now. This is all additional parts that we have. We're trying things out to see how we can get the most effective setup. So let's go inside and see what we got. All right, we're inside, 13.27 volts. Again, these are temporary setups, so we can show you guys what's going on. This is a Renogy PWM 30 amp charge controller. It's set up to charge the 200 amp hour lithium battery. We basically have a meter coming in that's showing everything from the solar side, and then a meter going out that's showing everything after the charge controller directly into the battery down there, so we can actually gauge how much power we're harnessing. So if we take a look on the solar side here, you'll see that the bottom right number there is rotating. That's going to be the maximum amps that we've seen, was 12.18. The maximum volts is 13.7. Maximum wattage is 168.7. And we've charged 2.6 or 2.7 amp hours or 36 watt hours. Now that's directly off the solar panel, what the solar panels are producing. Then it comes through to the charge controller and it'll come out this side, and we'll take a look at what we got going on here. 165 watts peak, 4.3 amp hours. So a good amount more amp hours there, 58 watt hours. So the PWM charge controller has stepped up the amperage and whatnot just a little bit. We noticed when we turned it on in the morning that it was getting about 0.2 to 0.3 more amps going into the battery. It looks like now it's starting to level out. So we'll let it run the whole day. We'll come back and we'll see. Again, that magic number we wanna see is about 1,000 watt hours. We'll see what happens. All right, everyone, the 200 watts of solar have been out in the sun about 5 hours or so. We have not moved them, just kind of left them due south, roughly due south. And the sun will peer over the trees soon, so we'll start to lose some power. We'll go inside and see what we got so far. All right, 13.50 on the battery. We'll go over and look at the solar panel side first. That's 38 amp hours charged so far, or 538 watt hours. 181 watts coming in right now on the solar side, or sorry, after the charge controller when it does its conversion in there. We've got 841 watt hours so far charged. That's amazing, actually. That's more than I thought. 175 watts going in. So we got a little bit of a loss, about a 5-6 watt loss, which equates to about 0.2 amps. 200 watts was our peak. So you're showing 200 watts. That's 61 amp hours charged so far. So that's doing really well. Maybe we'll get to 100 amp hours here with this 200 watt system. It just goes to show you that as long as it's set up properly and you size your expectations, you know, you'll get a good outcome. All right, it is about 4:30. The sun is off of the panels mostly. We're gonna go inside and see what we harvested. All right, 13.39 volts. We got 630 watt hours from the solar panels directly at almost 15 amps peak. About 45 amp hours. So then that came through the charge controller here, which is a PWM pulse width modulation. And it came down to here where we've seen 203 watts peak, which is about normal. 71, almost 72 amp hours, so substantially more. 984 watt hours. So these things almost put out what they're supposed to put out brand new. Harbor Freight says they do about 500 watt hours a piece. This is end of October, beginning of November. So in the summertime, they're only going to do better. So that's what you can really expect from the solar panels. Now we'll bring up a little sheet and show you the comparison.